Perfection in self-realization cannot be attained by any kind of yogi unless he engages in devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, because that is the only auspicious path.
Na jujjamanaya bhaktya bhagavata kilatmani sadisosti shiva panthya yoginam brahma siddhaya. Yogi means connecting. And Brahma Siddhaya means self-realization. Ang Brahmasmi, simply to know that I am spirit soul is not sufficient. It must be farther advanced. Then it will be siddha, perfection. Brahma siddha. To realize I am Brahma, aham brahmasmi, that is not sufficient. You have to make further progress. Just like to become feverless. Suppose one is suffering from fever, so medicine is given and the no more fever stop. That is not sufficient. Not only fever should stop, but you should get strength, you should get appetite, you should have normal life, then it is perfect cure of the disease. Similarly, Brahma Siddhaya, to realize that I am the spirit soul, is not sufficient. You have to be engaged in the spiritual activity. That is bhakti. Bhakti means spiritual activities. There is activity, it is not. The Mayavadi philosopher, they think that stop material activities. Brahma, Satya, Jagan, Mitha. Why you are engaged? The Buddhist philosophy also, they say nirman. Stop this material life. The Buddhist philosophers, they do not give more information. We are suffering on account of this material combination. That is their philosophy. because this body is nothing but combination of earth, water, fire, air, mind, intelligence, and ego. So if you separate it, let the earth go to the earth, let water go to the water, let fire go to the fire, then you become zero. If you dismantle, just like we dismantle some house, so there are so many things coming out. So let the doors be taken, somebody, windows, somebody, the bricks, somebody, and rubbish, somebody, then there is no house, zero. This is called Nibbana theory. No more existence. We are suffering pains and pleasure. Pains, there is no pleasure. Pleasure means accepting another type of pain. I am suffering, just like there is boil on your body, it is suffering, and to cure it, another suffering, surgical operation. So it is going on like that. Actually, there is no pleasure, there is only pain. So the Buddhist theory is to dismantle this construction, and then there is no more sense of pain. The Mahavadi theory also like that. Their activities, because they are material activities, therefore there are sufferings. So the material activities, they are false. You simply understand yourself that you are Brahma and no more activities, stop all activities, Brahma realization. Their example is given that if you take an empty pitcher and you put into the water, so long it is not filled up, there will be some sound, bud, 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 bud. And as soon as the pitcher is fully filled up, there is no more sound. So, all these Vedic mantra and other, they are only means. So, when one is completely Brahma realizes, then there is no more chanting, hearing, or Vedic hymns. Everything stops. The same theory. Buddhist theory and Mahavad theory is almost practically the same. They are saying, make it zero, and they are saying it is mitha, false, stop it. Brahma-satya-jagan. Brahma-satya means Brahma realization that I am Brahma. I am the same, supreme, so on. But that will not help you. That is simply theoretical. Practical is Vaktya Bhagavati Akhilatmani. Vaktya Bhagavati Akhilatmani. Bhagavan is everywhere. Ishavasamidam Sadvam. Ekappasau Rachayatam Jagadanna Koti. Jat Shakti Rasti Jagadanna Chayajadantam. Annantarasam Paramana Chayantarasam. Govindamadi Purusam Tamaham Bhajan. Akhila. Hari Ishara Bhagavan. Akhilatmani. Akhilatmani Bhakti. Bhakti, this word, is applicable only to the Supreme Personality of God. Therefore it is said here, Bhagavati Akhilatmani. Bhagavan is not alone, is not only localized. He is everywhere. Andantarasthang paramana chara chara chantarasthang goloko eva nivasati akhilatma bhuto. That is called akhilat. Although he has got a particular place, just like Krishna, he is here. He is in many other temples also. That is Krishna. It is not that Krishna, because he is in one place, he cannot be in other place. Just like we are conditioned. We are here. I am sitting here. You are sitting here. But you are not at your home, in your apartment. Krishna is not like that. Krishna, goloka eva nivasati akhila atma bhuto. He is always in the Golok Vrindavan. Still, he is annantarastham paramanuchayantarastham govindam adipurusham tavang bhaya. Annantarastham means he is within this universe. This universe, the whole universe, is going on because there is the Garbhodakshai Vishnu. Ekapasau rachayatam jagadanda koti. There are not only one anywhere, that koti, millions, and ekamsi nasthito jagat, one ansa of Krishna, that Garbhodakshai Vishnu, is there. Just like this body is working nicely, because the soul, the spirit soul, is within this body. Similarly, the whole universe, its activities are going nicely, regularly, everything, because the Garbhodakshai Vishnu is there. It is not difficult. Matter cannot work so nicely. Don't think that so many planets, they are floating in the air without any arrangement. There is arrangement. Annantarastham paramanuchayantarastham vishtabhya aham idam sarvam ekamsthena sito jagat. Therefore, Krishna is there, akhilatma. Krishna is super soul. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddhesha arjuna tishtat. Krishna, although localized, although he is always in his Golok Vrindavan dham, still he is everywhere. Therefore his name is akhilatma. Hari Ishara Bhagavan akhilatma Parameshwar, Paramatma, there are so many names. So here it is said, Najujjamanaya bhaktya bhagavati akhilatmani. If you engage yourself in devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is super soul or expanded everywhere, even in the atom, then your yoga system for Brahma Siddhaya, for self-realization, will not be complete. Siddhaya, jata tam api siddhyana, Garbhat is said, ya manushyanam sahasyesu kaschit jatati siddhaya. This siddhaya. Siddhaya means Brahma Siddhaya. Out of many millions and millions of persons, one is interested in Brahma Siddhaya. Nobody is interested. We are crying everywhere, please come. We have made this center. Please come and realize yourself and make your life perfect. But nobody is interested. Manushanam sahasyasu. Therefore Krishna said, out of millions and millions of persons, one may be interested. Similarly, there is a statement in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Eirupe brahmanna bhramite kono bhagyavana jeev guru krishna kripaya paya bhakti lata bij. Kono bhagyavana jeev, to come to Krishna consciousness is not very easy. It is meant for the most fortunate person. Kono bhagyavana jeev. Bhakti yog, to accept Krishna consciousness as bhakti yog, is not so easy. Therefore, general people, they are not interested. General people, they are not interested. Bhogai sajja prasaktanam taya apurita chitasam. Bhavasatmika buddhi samadhu na adhigacchati. Those who are too much materially interested, sense gratification, they are not very much interested in Krishna consciousness. They are not very much interested. So don't be disappointed that many people are not coming. It is a subject matter which is not for many people. One is selected. Just like if you inquire how many fools are there, you will find practically everyone is fool. But if you want to see how many MAs are there, it will be very difficult to find out. So it is by Krishna's, Lord Chaitanya's mercy that we are preaching Krishna consciousness all over the world, and the fortunate, those who are very, very fortunate, they are coming to it. Otherwise, it is not very easy thing that people are interested in Brahma Siddha. Brahma-siddha means complete self-realization, a perfect self-realization. That is called Brahma-siddha. To understand, first of all, Brahma, jnana-vairagya-yuktena, that is also bhakti-yuktena. In previous verse, we have discussed that jnana-vairagya-yuktena, bhakti-yuktena, ca-atmana, Puripasyati udasinam prakritim ca hatojasam. To be less influenced by the material modes of life, one has to come to this platform of jnana, vairagya and bhakti. Otherwise it is not possible. And that the same process being stressed again, najajyamānāya bhaktiya bhagavati bhakti, where it is to be applied. Somebody said, I have got bhakti. Where you have got bhakti? Now I have got very much bhakti to my wife. I love him. I love her very much. I take care of her. If I do not see her, I become mad. So this kind of bhakti is not explained here. I have got bhakti for my family, I have got bhakti for my country, I have got bhakti for Goddess Durga, I have got bhakti for so many demigods. No, that kind of bhakti will not do. Therefore it is particularly said, bhakta bhagavati, bhagavati. And to the Supreme. What kind of Bhagavan? Nowadays there are so many Bhagavans. No, not that kind of imitation Bhagavan. But what kind of? Akhilatmani. You ask this so-called imitation Bhagavan, are you Akhilatman? Are you present in everyone's heart? Can you say what I am thinking now? So Bhagavan means he must be Akhilatman. Don't be misled by so-called Bhagavan. Everything is there. Bhagavan means Akhilatman. He knows. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Ishvara sarva bhutanam rishdeshe. If you are Ishvara, then you must be present in everyone's heart. Sarvasya chaham ridhishannivishtya. Ishvara, Krishna is Ishvara. Therefore he said, sarvasya chaham ridhishannivishtya. I am staying in everyone's heart. So if you are Ishvara, if you are Bhagavan, are you staying in my heart? Do you know what I am thinking now? So, akhilatmani. Everything should be very scrutinizedly studied. Bhakti is only for Bhagavan. Not that my bhakti for this or that, for this demigod, for that demigod, for my family, for my country, for my society, for my wife, for my cat, for my dog. This is not bhakti. They are imitation. That is lust, that is desire, that is not bhakti. Bhakti means Bhagavati. Bhagavati means Akhilatmani. So if we can develop that Krishna consciousness, bhakti, then our life, successful life, Brahma Siddha, complete self-realization will be possible. Therefore it is said, Sadrisha Asti Shiva Pantha. No. There is no other alternative. If you Brahma Siddha, Brahma Parabrahma is Krishna. Brahma Siddha means to understand what is the relationship. I am Brahma. That's all right. Aham Brahmasmi. But what is your relation with the power of Brahma? That is Brahma Siddhi. Brahma and power of Brahma, there are two Brahmas. Why there is Atma and Paramatma, Ishvara and Parameshvara. So, living being and the supreme being, Nitya Nityana, Chetana Chetanana. These are the Vedic information. There are two, always two. Atma, Paramatma. Brahma, Parabrahma. And Brahma Siddha means not only to understand that I am Brahma, but I must understand what is my relationship with Parabrahma. That is Brahma Siddha. That means we must know what is Parabrahma. That Parabrahma is Krishna. Parabrahma param dhamam pavitam paramam bhavan. Purusam shasatam dibbam. We must know what is my relationship. That relationship is already explained. That I am qualitatively one. Brahma and Parabrahma means both of them, one in the platform of being Brahma. But Parabrahma is very, very great, and I am simply Brahma, small. And the Vedic instruction is not Ahang Parabrahma, never said it. Ahang Brahma, that is all right. But you cannot say, I am Parabrahma. Nobody says. There is no such maxim in the Vedic literature. Parabrahma is one, Kaivalya. Kaivalya means there is no alternative, there is no duplicate, there is no equal, there is no greater than. That is Kaivalya. So nobody can be equal to Parabrahma, and nobody can be greater than Parabrahma. That is Parabrahma. So Brahma Siddhaya means simply one should not understand that I am Brahma, but he must understand what his relationship with the Parabrahma. That is Brahma Siddhi. So for Brahma Siddhi, for self-realization, people are trying in so many ways. First of all, the business of human life is only meant for this purpose, Brahma Siddhaya. So long we are, athāta brahma jignāsa. This is the Vedānta Sutra. Brahma, because unless you become inquisitive, then how there can be Brahma Siddhi? Therefore, this human life is meant for Brahma Jignasa. Not that simply whole day war. They are also inquiring. They go to the market. What is the price? What is the rate? The whole day. In share market you go, kya bhav hai? Everyone is asking. Not for that kind of question. That everyone is questioning from the morning. What is today's news? Immediately newspaper, what is the news? Then it is, no more. Then you go to the market. What is the price of rice? What is the price of this? What is the price of that? So purchase. Then you eat. Then you go to the office or market. Then again, what is the price? What is the... Not that kind of inquiry. That is going on. That is also going on by the cats and dogs. They are also inquiring, where is food, where is remnants of foods, where they are thrown out, so that I can go, I can check. The crows are also doing that, that kind of question. But you should not waste your time like the cats and dogs and crows by inquiring, where is food, where is food, where is food. Food is there for you, fixed up. Don't bother. The Bhagavad says there, tasyaiva hi ta prajate ta kovida nalabhate jat bhramatam uparjata. Now, not only in cats and dogs' life, even in heavenly life and other life, we are simply inquiring, where is my sense gratification, where is my sense gratification? That kind of inquiry will not help you. Tasyaiva hi ta prajate ta. You should inquire for something which you never did before. That is Brahma Jignasa. Athātha Brahma Jignasa. What I am? I am thinking I am this body and I am engaged, but actually I do not get any pleasure, any happiness. But when I get information that when you will be realized, self-realized, Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma. When you will be self-realized, Brahma realized, then you will be Prasannatma. Jasmin Vijnati Sarvamedam Vijnatam Bhavanti Janglabdhya Chaparangalabhang Mannati Nadhikang Tataha. These are the Shastric injunctions. So, this life is meant for Brahma Jignasa. This life, this human life is meant for Brahma Jignasa. Other Jignasa, inquiries, that is in the cats and dogs and hawks and crows and everywhere. So, don't be bothering. If I don't bother, then how shall I eat? That people generally say, that everyone becomes Krishna conscious. How we shall eat? How things will go? Now we are Krishna conscious, practical example. Are you not eating? Are you not sleeping? What business is stopped? We have no business. We simply beg. There is no certainty that tomorrow I shall go there, I'll get this money. There is no certainty. We do not know. We are eating in the morning. We do not know whether there will be food in the evening. If Krishna gives, then we can eat. You know it very well. We have no business. We are not professional men. We are not going to the market for what is bhav, kya bhav hai. No. So are you not eating? We are eating, not only eating, we have got 102 branches, and every branch there are at least 100 men. They are all eating. Why? Because we know Krishna will give us. Krishna giving food to the ants, to the elephant. Why not to his servant? We have no. If you have got this confidence, then this Shastra says, Tasyaiva heta prajateta kovida. You should simply try for perfection of life, brahma jignasa. Athata brahma jignasa. Janmadasya. This is the only. Jivasya tatta jignasa. This is the only business. What I am. The answer is aham brahma. Soham. I am same brahma. So then what is my relation with the Param Brahma? Jigyasu Seva Uttamam. Now, when there is question of Jigyasa, Brahma Jigyasa, then we inquire from a person who knows. Therefore it is said that Tasmad Gurum Prabhadeta Jigyasu Seva Uttamam. If you are actually interested in inquiring about Brahma, then you must go to Guru who knows Brahma. Tasmat Gurum Prapadeta. You cannot understand Brahma realization alone. Therefore, according to Vaishnava philosophy, Adau Gurbhasram, the first business is to take shelter of a bona fide spiritual master. If you want, not only Brahma Jigyasa, any, you must go to the perfect person who knows things. If you are wandering on some street you do not know, you ask somebody, where shall I go, in this way or that way. So this is natural. So about Brahma Jigyasa, Brahma Jigyasa means that is not ordinary Jigyasa. It is called uttamam. Uttamam means transcendental to this material world which is full of darkness, ignorance. That is called ut. Udgata tamam jasmat iti uttam. There is no more darkness, simply light. If you, at night, you inquire about something, then it is very difficult. But if you go in the daytime, and at night if you got up on your roof and want to see where is Bombay or where is Santa Cruz, it is very difficult. But daytime you can see. Similarly, uttamam, you must go out of this darkness, come to the light, and then you will see. So that light is given by Guru. Ajñāna-timirāndhasya jñānānjana-salākaya. That light is given not by bringing one torch light, but jñānānjana-salākaya. The light of knowledge. The light of jñānānjana-salākaya. Chakṣur-unumilitāma-jīna-tasmai-sī-gurave. Guru's business is to give you light by knowledge. Then you understand. Tasmāt guruṁ prapadyeta jigyāsu śrī uttamam. How the gyan, knowledge, light is given? Śābdi parecha nisnātam brahmani upasamāśrayam. This is the guru's system, guru's symptom. What is guru? Śābdi parecha nisnātam. He has completely assimilated the Vedic essence of life. That is called Guru. And what is Shabda Shastra or Vedas? Shruti Shastra. Shruti means Veda, knowledge. Veda means knowledge. Knowledge is received through ear, by hearing. That is real knowledge, not by experimental knowledge. You cannot understand which is beyond your sense perception by experiment. Just like you cannot understand who is your father by experimental knowledge. Let me make experiment and find out who is my father. That is not possible. Because it is beyond your experience. Your father was existing when you are not existing. Then how you can understand by experimental knowledge? The authority is mother. Therefore, Vedic knowledge is the mother. The Puranas are the sisters. They are explained like that. You should understand from the Vedas what is the ultimate knowledge. And Krishna says, Vedaishta sarvai ahameva vedam. The ultimate knowable objective is Krishna. So simply by understanding Krishna, jasmin vijnate sarvamedam vijnatam bhavanti. If you can simply understand Krishna, then you understand everything. You haven't got to understand separately Krishna's enlightenment. Tesamaham. What is that word? Samudhritya. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Tesam evanu kampartham aham agyana jangatama nasayami ātma-bhāvastha jñāna-dīpena-bhāsa. If you actually come in contact with Krishna, and Krishna is within your heart, Krishna is not far away, Krishna is everywhere, but is still nearer, he is within your heart, Īśvara-sa. So if you become attached to Krishna, when Krishna sees, now you are attached to Krishna, then riddhantastha avadrani vidhunati suhitsata. He is friend of the devotees. He is friend of everyone, but a special friend of the devotees. Suhitsata. Therefore, you have to become a devotee. Therefore, it is said, najajjamanaya bhaktya. Bhaktya means devotee. Who performs devotional service unless he is a devotee? Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, bhaktyamam avijanat. So, if we become devotee, if we take to devotional service, then Krishna says, tesam aham anukampartham, for special favor. Special favor. What is that? Tesam evaham anukampartham aham agyanajam tamo nasayam. Krishna says, I kill all kinds of ignorance. So simply this qualification required, that you become perfect devotee of Krishna. Then you perfectly become jnani. Jnana is there. Simply it is covered by the curtain of ignorance. Just like in darkness, everything is there. The light is there, everything is there, but as soon as it is dark, we cannot see where the things are there. So, Krishna says that anyone can understand himself, anyone can understand Krishna and the relationship, provided the darkness of ignorance is taken away. That is required. That is done by Krishna personally. For whom? Tesam evanukampa. Tisam satatajuktanang bhajatang pritipurbhaka. Those who are engaged 24 hours with love and faith in devotional service. Tisam satatajuktanang bhajatang pritipurbhakam dadami buddhijugam tam. Buddhijugam. He directs, do like this, do like that. Then, what for buddhi? Jenavam upajantite. Then gradually you come to Krishna, back to home, back to God. Therefore it is recommended here, najajjamanaya bhaktya bhagavati akhilatmane sadishosti shiva pantha. Shiva means auspicious. Shiva means auspicious. So if you actually interested for self-realization, If you want to become perfect in this life, Shiva Pantha, the most auspicious, most perfect Pantha is, what is that? Na Bhaktya Bhagavati. You just become a devotee and engage yourself in devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, not the so-called rascal Bhagavan, but Bhagavati Okhila Atman. That Bhagavan who is present everywhere. That Bhagavan. Not this false Bhagavan. Okhila Atmani. These are the shastric injunction. So, that Bhagavan, no, I don't find that Bhagavan. No, that Bhagavan is within your heart. Ishvara Sarvabhutanam, that is real Bhagavan. So, as tene brahmarida adhikabhai, that Bhagavan is always active. He instructed Brahma. Brahma, the Lord of the universe, he got instruction from Krishna and he created the whole universe. And what to speak of you? He'll also give instruction to you, provided you take to the devotional service, bhaktya, bhaktamamabhi.